Prostate cancer is one of the most common diseases that we face in oncology, and it's also one that has probably some of the greatest disparities in care. You know, why that is multifactorial, but we see, for instance, in the United States, about a 2 to 2.5-fold greater likelihood of African Americans dying from prostate cancer than white patients. And compared to, say, Asian Americans, it's like 5 to 1. So there's a dramatic difference here. And you know, socioeconomic factors, access issues are clearly a big, big driver of that, but not in all the driver of that. So we're recognizing there are also biologic determinants of this. One of the interesting things we found in some retrospective analyses was that African Americans, when they were treated on clinical trial with drugs, actually seemed to do as well or even maybe better in terms of responsiveness. So we wanted to test that prospectively, and we did a small kind of a pilot study, parallel group study, 50 African Americans, 50 Caucasian patients treated with the same therapy, abiraterone acetate, for castration-resistant prostate cancer, and we were able to reproduce that data that African Americans had a greater PSA response rate and a longer time to PSA progression compared to white counterparts. Now, the overall survival for the population was the same, but considering that across the country it's twofold higher for African Americans, I think this really suggests that there are biologic determinants here, as well as social determinants, that are factoring into that disparity. And when we eliminate those social determinants, African Americans may actually be doing better in some circumstances with therapy. So to us, the message is, gosh, we got to get these patients. One, we got to get these patients on trial. Two, we have to close that access gap. But three, we have to understand what those biologic determinants are by race and figure out then how to make sure we target those patients at the optimal time to really maximize that clinical benefit. What those biologic determinants are is still unknown, but we have some suspicions. Well, one, we think, you know, obviously this has got to be something inheritable. You know, this is a racial associated difference. So we know with race, it goes beyond the skin. We know that there's a whole complexity of differences that are inherited. And we know that this is the germline. So germline we think of as primarily inherited genes, but there could be also metabolism and protein levels that are differences by race. And so that's what we're looking at in our study. Because we did this study prospectively, we were able to collect historical tumor blocks as well as prospective blood at the time of starting the treatment as well as on study. So we're able to look at changes in hormonal level, changes in metabolic pathways, as well we've been able to look at the genetic determinants that are associated with these patients. Lastly, we're looking at, believe it or not, the drug itself. Abiraterone is a hormone. It is a steroid. And so it's transported into cells by the same mechanisms that testosterone and other hormones are transported in. So there may be pharmacokinetic differences associated with race that nobody's ever determined. And part of that, you know, is the fact that African Americans have been poorly represented on these clinical trials. Many of them are international studies. Their percentage involvement in these studies is in the single digits, low single digits. And that has to change.